almost over your head, that absorbs some of the downward energy. The flyby by DJ Dow, the C-53 from Grumman Air Force.
The show took place off the stern of the Queen Mary as part of a 1940s inspired entertainment venture, put on three times a day, every day for about 6 months. Has a 600 horsepower Pratt & Whitney R1340 radial engine with a supercharger, is 29 feet in length, has a wingspan of 42 feet, has a top speed of 250 miles an hour, the stall speed is 60, and weighs over 5,000 pounds. The propeller is 108 inches long, and the distinctive sound you hear coming from Wardog is the sound of the propeller tips going supersonic. The North American T-6 Texan was designed as an advanced fighter trainer in the late 1930s. World War II pilots started training on the primary trainer, the Stearman, which you saw flown earlier today, and then moved into the advanced trainer T-6 and eventually onto fighters, such as the P-51 Mustang. The basic Texan design underwent constant modifications. It gave the best possible training for all types of tactics, from ground strafing to bombardment and aerial dogfighting. Some of the equipment typically found on the T-6 includes bomb racks, blind instrumentation, standard cameras, and 30 caliber fixed and flexible guns. During the Korean War, the U.S. Air Force and Marine Corps used the plane as forward air controllers. Over 15,000 examples were produced. The last model was produced in the early 1950s. In the early days of the Blue Angels, they used a T-6 SNJ-5, like War Dog, as part of their tactical demonstration. She was painted yellow and called Beetle Bomb, and during simulated dogfighting, the Blue Angels used F-6F Hellcats to shoot her down. Later today, you'll be seeing one of those Hellcats flying, so that's really going to be special. You have gotten to see many of the military training and advanced fighters and bombers, everything today. It's an incredible show. The military of today has bestowed a great honor on the T-6 Texan, naming its current state-of-the-art trainer the Texan II. Did you see that, ladies and gentlemen, as John went upside down in his role? The gear came out. This signifies he's getting close to the end of the show. He's going to turn around here and give you a wave with the wave. veterans, please raise your hand. Everyone else, please put your hands together to thank our military and veterans for their service. John and Wardock salute you. We all thank you for the freedoms we enjoy and the many sacrifices of you have made. Thank you. John's waving at you, thanking you.
Let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come on and fly with me. Let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come on, fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You may hear all the angels cheer, because we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. Just say the words and we'll beat the birds down to Acapulco Bay. It is perfect for a flying honeymoon. They say, come fly with me, let's fly away. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so very near. You might even hear a whole gang of cheers, just because we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a cuckoo day. You just say those words and we'll take our birds down to Acapulco Bay. It's so perfect for a flying honeymoon. Oh, babe, come fly with me. Let's fly, let's fly. Pack up, let's fly away. Pack a small bag.